Yeah, first game of the day. Solo and Lil together in the mid lane trying to wrap around. They'll have to go all the way around the Tinker if they want him, unless Cuckoo stands its ground like he just did. The Nova will slow him down. Lil's able to get the crush, has to get outside the March of the Machines. Cuckoo, one last attack from Crystal Maiden will actually do the job, but they lose the Magnus in return.
Motivation's tough to come by. It's hard enough to just get yourself a go.
Here they go again on bottom lane. Raven, open wound. Solo's coming in close. VP been waiting for this. The Frostbite's available, and Terrorblade doesn't have Sunder because Pasha attacked before. Raven can't just Sunder himself out this one. The Shellgrave will keep him alive. Is there another heal? Not in time. So Nyx Assassin has to do the work. Spire Carapace something on Solo, allowing the double kick from Timbs, combining up with the Silence, the Crush. Lil's still looking for the good timing. He's got it. Nyx Assassin plus Timbs getting caught out from that one. Nyx wants to attack from the rear. Now he finally will. Hits into Pasha. A follow-up, a secondary is done, connecting on Solo in the tree line, and with the help from Cuckoo, they will have, or should have enough damage if they can just get Vision on Solo again. The stun's off cooldown in 2 seconds time for that impale of Sam, and this should be the icing on the cake. He'll try and do it. No, he'll just do it with a stun. It's fight time for VP. Lil's gonna come up to the top lane, takes, loses one third of his life for the Rockets, make it three quarters. And he's going to go back into the March of the Machines. The Spectral Horn is out, looking for his primary target. The kick actually connects onto Solo. Tim hits the mark, and that means the follow-up stun onto Ramses will bring him down. Raven will pick up a double kill. Not even really tested, had the Sunder available as well. It'll be a glorious play. For now, Raven triggers Metamorphosis, and TNC, they start their pressure. Tinker will arrive. They need some vision up high ground. Pasha actually going in with Lil's the Blink Crush. Nyx Assassin, he's the one that has to be Spike Harris in the RP! There it is! Four heroes caught with the cleave damage! TNC! They'll lose practically everything. The Aegis Immortal will trigger. So Terrorblade comes back to World of the Living, caught around by three heroes. Raven tries to fight. Sunder is available, so he'll steal the life from Pasha, but Ramses moves back up again. And Virtus Pro, they hold the line. Farming there, but TNC looks like they're ready to fight for the Blink. Crush falls, Spectral Haunt, Raven. They force off him deeper into it, but he sunders over on Lil, taking away that life with the Nyx stun. Lil will end up falling, and the RP, it'll connect on two. No Shellgrave available, so skewer them back into the freezing field. Earth Spirit and Terrorblade pushing up the Daisy Sam, try to get him. Now he has to back up, but Cuckoo from the tree line with the Master Machines down and the continuous spam. He doesn't have enough damage to kill up no one as no one is able to jump Invis, but Pasha under the tower, he can toggle through that damage.
Yeah, he should be up close to the tail end of this push, and Raven wastes no time trying to make this a strict 4-on-5, and they just have to be careful not to be baited in by a big RP.
Well, they're using Raven as the bait. There's your Blink Crush. It's over on the Tinker, and they have to keep pushing Cuckoo away. He had to tank the Shallow Grave, which allows the Dazzle now to fall. A good double stun from Sam creates more space. Raven wants to fight, but here they come. The kick was perfect. Perfect from Timbs, cancelling off the RP and killing off the Magnus. Mag will now buy back. Pasha standing his ground, gets the bash onto Raven. It may just be enough with a follow-up crush from Lil. They'll do the work, but Timbs is there once again, working with Sam H to ensure some level of rebuttal. And now Lil, the silence again, and Cuckoo arrives, the laser, the rockets, here goes your RP from no one. Solo, what have you got left? The freezing field, that won't do it, the Spike Carapace instantly cancels it, so Solo has to go on the run, no one protects himself with his own shrine, Solo's the man who'll have to take it again for the team inside the tree lines, the rolling boulder fall, but Cuckoo found the kill. How much damage can they do? They can look to the range racks while three heroes from VP are down with no buybacks available. It actually triggers, so amplification can now come up. So they have the extra damage, but TNC, they are so close. The weave connects on the three heroes. They know what's going on. The three man's done. Maybe with the RP on the back lines, no one in the cover. The BKB will do the work. Roshan, Aegis Immortal does go the way of Ramses. No one, actually Raven, able to sunder him, but still not enough to stay alive. Ramses has himself a double kill, looking for more. Three heroes down for TNC. And it's Sam H, Spike Carapace, follow-up stuns. He can't even trigger the Aegis from spec. And they have to basically prepare the fact there is Observer Wars, but then BKB, the RP, able to connect perfectly. Dazzle's already down, so no Shallow Grave here for the fight. Terrorblade, now the Metamorphosis will be triggered. You'll find Solo going down the tree line. Sim has to rolling boulder away. It was Ramses, who's just in the thick of it underneath Cuckoo. But VP retreat back out again. Nyx Assassin wants to go for more. A quick Yule Scepter doesn't have the sun available. For some reason, the E-Blade popped his a melee creep looking for a Lifestealer. They're going in with no RP, with no Spectral Haunt, and you still have the Metamorphosis up. Raven's doing his work. They get the melee racks down the bottom lane. So TNC still get the objective they were looking for, so they can just retreat out. So you can't even set up the Infest combo with Pasha.
And Aegis is down. Ramzes, his life is at risk.
There goes the tier 3. Bit by bit, TNC claiming the buildings inside VP's base. The Hex is there, the RP will connect for the kick from Tibbs! Perfect, the form silence, BKB from no one. It may be enough, the cleave is still doing his work, the Shallow Grave is out. It's actually protecting the Terrorblade, who was able to sunder himself back up, but Ramzes, he needs to die, and Raven's able to oblige, not to mention Tibbs. Another three-man stun. This guy is a god. The buyback will come in from the spec, allowing him now to haunt forward. Raven will fall, and this will be a costly defense, but a defense nonetheless from Virtus Pro. Tinker needs a TP out, needs something, but Cuckoo, Rearm, can't do it in time, not while the Shallow Grave is there. How far do you want to go with this one? There's no Tinker, there's no Dazzle. Do you feel you got enough for a GG push? Or do you try and counter the racks? They're going to go for the racks instead, but the tier 2 towers are up, so they can't go for anything more than the mid. But yep, here we go. They're going to go straight for the tier 4 towers. Virtus Pro, there will be a 3-man kick from Tibbs delaying this up, and Virtus Pro, including a 2-man silence, will now walk outside of the TNC base. Exact moment, but you look at TNC, they're also coming in. The smoke's going to break. No one. This is time. The BKB plus the ulti. Remember, he's going to have the secondary one thanks to Refresher Orb, so skewer forward. Secondary RP. You'll also have to buy space for Nyx Assassin, but Sam, the Shallow Grave is keeping him alive, but it won't be the same for the Terrorblade. He will fall, and Ramzes looking for the haunt. He wants a secondary target. He jumped up to the top lane after using the Refresher Orb. And then pushes the lane. Lil ready to come in, looking for the fight and a quick reflect. They want to go for more with a follow-up stun. Now Spectre gonna haunt in. No one looks for the RP, but where is it? Now will go down, catching up the Terrorblade. The skewer forward. He's only found one. That's a big one. Cuckoo will fall. We'll have the buyback from Cuckoo. He needs to get back in of this one. The Shallow Grave Terrorblade Sunder. He lets it go and gets pushed up on top of the hill. Now it's King of the Castle play. Terrorblade will survive. His Manta doesn't even get him down from there. Someone's gonna force up. That'll get him down. No slaughter for 100 seconds. Spec does have buyback, 114 seconds. He could potentially wait, but that's way too long. And Cuckoo is on the hunt. Needs to rearm, get closer, gets the Hex over on the Magnus. Support is there. Sam will get the, not the double stun. The Rage is off in time. Ramzes buys back, triggers a Refresher Orb. They're looking for more kills on the back of that Haunt. Tibbs is the man on the run. He's gonna rolling ball it down over the hill and blinks up and TPs away.
Holy shit,
the buyback is out and he will survive.
I cannot believe that Tibbs just saved him right there. That was so crucial.
He looks towards the ranks. This will force VP into some level of engagement. The kick was trying to create a little bit more space. There's a Frostbite over on Raven. That melee rack has dropped down low, but not low enough.
Tim's Earth Spirit.
First right out. They still don't have the double RP. No one's waiting for the perfect opportunity, but it's Terrorblade. They know he's waiting to drop down low so then he can Sunder, and he does it over on Pasha. He dodges the Lotus Orb target, but Raven drop down low. They'll need the Shallow Grave. Raven, there it is. He'll keep himself alive. RP is out. It's the control there long enough. They four-staff him down. There's the Sunder, another four-staff. Raven will fall down solo. Value Nova finds the kill. Tim puts the rolling ball around. He'll actually roll right into the middle of Pasha. Terrorblade will buy back. And the freaking Lifestealer, Pasha, have just been holding hands this entire time. And he walks straight into them. The Hex will be there. This will be a big opening if they can actually get both of the kills. Slaughter's down for 2 minutes with a follow-up stun. The window has been left open from Virtus Pro. Lifestealer will have a buyback, but with no slaughter, no amplification.
I'd be more surprised if RP wasn't cast.
Yeah. On a failed RP. Okay. That's more of a negative way of looking at the fight before it happens.
It technically, it would still land on RP.
There's your jump forward. Ramzes already copying a fair chunk of damage from Raven. They protect them both with Lotus Orbs. But Ramzes, not too healthy, has the Aegis. It looks like it's about to trigger. He's so low. 100. He went down to 20 HP. Still surviving. So there goes the Aegis Immortal and the Skewer. They can hold him there, but no one actually gets stunned. Raven, the RP has to come out from no one. Hold him in position. Solo now lets it go, but Raven, the damage is again too much. Solo has to back up a little bit further, get away from the next assassin. Secondary RP committed, but Raven, another saving grace. They're just holding him there. He'll sunder his own Dazzle, the man that kept him alive. He had to sunder his own teammate. Refresh, roll about, create more chaos. Virtus Pro, the defense. Terrorblade is finally brought down. Tinker will join him. They're both dead for 2 minutes. With this window that was meant to be open for TNC, VP shut it closed and then shatter the glass. Keep delaying the game, keep split pushing until you get some level of opening against Virtus Pro.
They have lane issues right now. This is...
Oh, the crush. Sam, quick yules up. Spine Carapace is available, so is E-Blade, so is 4-star, but when he keeps getting bashed by Lil, he has to E-Blade himself. 4-star into Blink. No, he just got one little bit of damage into him, so he's incapable of blinking. Now Nyx Assassin is dead for 2 minutes.
What the buyback status is. 30 seconds left on Terrorblade, so his respawn timer is actually like 30 seconds, but that is way too long. I think this is gone.
It's gone.
They're like, what? They don't have buybacks? Oh god, let's just end right here.
Yeah, Tims is trying, but no one blinked in front of him, canceling the rolling boulder out, and Tims is doing everything he possibly can. Another crush, but Pasha will come in. That's the game. That's VP taking game one in 74 minutes and 26 seconds against TNC. Hard fought game one.
Wow, what do you say after that? Brilliant. Superb. Ridiculous. What a great way to start the opening of day two here in the group stages.